You want to support Roller March Unfiltered? Be sure to join our Bring the Funk fan club. Every dollar that you give to us supports our daily digital show. There's only one daily digital show out here that keeps it black and keep it real. It's Roland Martin Unfiltered. Support the Roland Martin Unfiltered daily digital show by going to RolandMartinUnfiltered.com. You can make this possible.
Georgia, we are here, though, in Dallas, where tomorrow early voting begins all across Texas. It was supposed to start later, but the governor did it 6 days earlier because of coronavirus. Now, he's been doing some other stuff as well. We'll talk about that a little bit later. Joining us right now is the senior pastor of Friendship West Baptist Church, Reverend Dr. Frederick Douglass Haynes III. Pastor, glad to have you here. We are, again, first of all, how did this come about? How did this come about utilizing your facility as a super voting site?
Well, again, it speaks to the power of all politics is local. Commissioner Price, who I think you'll be interviewing later, was the one that hooked up this as a super voting site. We've been a voting site through the years, but because of the power of electing on a local level those who represent the community, we were able to use our church. We've got 150,000 square feet right here, and use our church as a super voting site in the community. And of course, it's something that we can control by way of sanitizing, by way of ensuring that people can safely vote. So all of that was done because of local politics. So yeah, the presidential election is extremely important, but at the same time, all politics is still local.
Now, of course, I was actually doing some walking earlier, and literally it's a mile all the way around. So you also have the advantage. You also have the advantage of having social distancing. So right. If there can be massive lines, you have it. And also, people can utilize the parking lot as well. And so what is their plan tomorrow? Let's say, like the lines we saw in Georgia, what's your plan to be able to, or what's their plan in order for to sort of get people in and out? Will they have them out of their cars? Will they tell them stay in their cars? How are they going to do it?
It's we have a multiple approach. On one level, those who are disabled, for example, differently abled, they can literally have people come out to the car where they can vote in the car. So again, we have 1,800 parking spaces here, so we'll be able to not only socially distance but serve those who perhaps cannot come in. I have a member of this church, Barbara Record, who cannot wait to vote tomorrow, but she can't get out of her car, but she knows she can come here and she's going to be served. So the setup is that you're going to have persons from the church who are going to be serving water, making sure that people stay hydrated. We're going to ensure that this is a safe space to vote, because we've discovered, given all the dynamics you've already revealed, if you're going to vote, you got to have a plan. But the community has to have a plan as well to make sure that we can all vote safely.
I'll tell you this here. It was so interesting because when I was getting my morning walk in, it was an old black woman with a beat up car with a handicap sticker, and she was driving around in the parking lot, and she said, is this where voting is tomorrow?
Right, right.
And I told her, yes, it is. And she said, do you know how they're going to do it? I said, ma'am, I don't know. They're setting up right now. But she came, she did her own pre-check.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I mean, and so are you hearing that as well, where folks are really, just like we're seeing in Georgia and other places, they are absolutely fired up to vote tomorrow?
To vote tomorrow, to vote early. I mean, and not only that, but they're planning how they're going to strategically come up with the ability to vote. So the powerful thing is, man, there's an energy about this election that I think the Republicans have a right to be scared about. That's why they're playing, what, ruthless checkers, I mean chess, while we're busy playing checkers. But the beautiful thing is we've got an energy, and with the enlightenment that programs like yours give, we can start playing chess as we deal with these ruthless Republicans.
Also, I think one of the things that we also are seeing and experiencing, we are seeing where we're actually seeing African Americans not just say, my vote matters. We're seeing them also acknowledge that I got to grab other people as well.
Right.
I think, and look, I've done this a whole lot. I think people this election are even more attuned to the issues top to bottom. Normally,
right,
in a presidential election,
right,
it's all about the top. But here in Texas, Democrats could very well take over the Texas House.
Yeah.
You have a lot of other local races. There's a black woman in Galveston who's running for a judicial position, will be the first African-American woman elected as well. In 2018 midterms, when I went to Houston, I helped out 18 black women who won judicial positions all across Harris County as well. We'll be in Harris County tomorrow at the Fountain of Praise Church with Black Voters Matter. And so what we are seeing again, and I think this is where the constant voter education comes in,
right,
letting our people know it matters top to bottom.
Right. And the beautiful thing is you have organizations now that are more active than they normally have been. Right here in Dallas, the Divine Nine has been engaged in voter both education and registration. We've had several events right with this church, not to mention other churches that normally may not have dibbled and dabbled in politics, they would call it, but they're recognizing how important, how crucial, and how dangerous this election is if we do not mobilize and educate our people as it relates to the importance of this election.
All right, Pastor Haynes, we certainly appreciate it. First of all, glad to see Friendship West is doing this. Glad you also allowed us to do the show from here. And just so some of y'all know, I used to be a member here.
Thank you.
So my tithes also made this possible.
That's right.
So just want to let y'all know that.
Say that. And I love your microphone, too.
Yeah, I figured you would.
I love your microphone.
You know what? I was going to do that one myself. I was going to use. I said, you know what?
No, you got to
leave the black and gold
thank
microphone.
You. Thank you.
And he probably will pick up on
thank
that
you.
Real
thank
quick.
You got the ring, so at least let me have the mic.
I got the alpha ring here, so you got that here. Pastor Haynes, I appreciate it. All right, folks, back to our Roll Mark Uncultured video in just one moment. All right, folks, at Seek.com, black-owned company founded by Mary Spio. They, of course, a virtual reality company. You can check out their content at Seek.com, C-E-E-K.com. You can do so, of course, with these VR headsets. You can look at it, of course, on your regular device or your pad or your computer. But if you want to experience being in the room, you can use this headset right here. All you simply do is just pop in your cell phone in here, pop it on, and then put this headset on, and you can literally experience their content in virtual reality. And so allows for you to do a 360-degree view of the room. But also, folks, they have the 360-degree 4D headphones right here. These are Bluetooth headphones. They have complete surround sound in terms of as you hear the particular music. Gamers love them as well when they're playing their games. And so it's just phenomenal bass in these headphones as well. You can get one or both devices at Seek.com using this promo code RMVIP 2020, RMVIP 2020. So we certainly thank the folks at Seek.com for being a partner with us here at Roland Martin Unfiltered. All right.